I see you gather before me. Hungry, terrified, clutching your babes to your breast. Emperor Emir has marched his legions into our lands, laid siege to every fortress from here to the Blue Mountains. Rabid and ravenous, he bites and bites away. Men of the North! You stand at the precipice. Your kings have failed you, so now you turn to the gods. And yet you do not plead. You do not kneel to dust your heads with ash. Instead, you wail, why have the gods forsaken us? We must look into the trials we failed long ago. In a time past, our world intertwined with another through an upheaval scholars call the conjunction of the spheres. The gods allowed unholy forces to slip into our domain. The offspring of that cataclysm was the nefarious force called magic. Yet we did not banish it, instead studying the vile arcane for our own power and wealth. And the monsters at our door, the unholy relics of this conjunction. The trolls, the corpse eaters, the werewolves. Did we raise our swords against them? Or have we laid this burden on others? On so-called witches. Stray children taught the ways of foul sorcery, their bodies mutated through blasphemous ritual. Sent to fight monsters, though they could not distinguish good from evil. The flicker of humanity, long extinguished within them. Yes, their numbers have dwindled through the years. But a few still roam our lands, offering their bloody work for coin. To this day, they shame us with their very existence. The North bleeds, flogged by war. The battles are the gods' whip, chastisement for our sins. And let us not forget the terrors, the scourges from beyond our world. The Wild Hunt rides the sky with every full moon. The Dark Raiders abduct our children into lands unknown. Some say they herald a second conjunction. Can we chart a course back into the light? Will we find the strength to banish the mages from our kingdoms? Unite around the warmth of the eternal fire. Nigh is the time of the sword and axe. None will fight this war in our stead. Nigh! It's the time of madness and disdain.
I don't find that amusing.
It wasn't meant to amuse, but to prod you to hurry. It's midday already. You promised Ciri you'd train with her. Go before Vesemir bores her to death with those etchings.
So, later then.
See you later.
You're running out of juice.
I know. You might bring me some more once you're done training.
Witcher's fast asleep. Ciri's disappeared somewhere, of course. Guess she prefers practice to theory.
Why?
Time to wake up, Master. These lessons so boring they put you to sleep too?
Damn it. Better taking notes on ghouls and al-ghouls. Wanted to rest my eyes a bit.
Making her slog through that brick? No wonder she took off.
John of Bruges lacks flair, true, but he's reliable. Not like the hogwash they print nowadays. She's tackling the pendulums, right? How many times do I have to tell her? Don't train alone. It only embeds your errors. Bring our young damsel to the lower courtyard. She wants to practice, she'll get to practice.
Don't get mad at her.
Why the hell not? The whippersnapper refuses to do as she's told.
You like that about her?
Fine. I suppose I'm partly to blame. But this has to end. Now. Killing monsters is not something to be taken lightly. Ciri must understand that if she's to become one of us. I'll see you below.
wrong. Now I see why you were so eager to practice. Strike. Pirouette. Wrong. Footwork. Enough. Get down.
With a flip?
What do you think? All right. Take off the blindfold. You've got work to do. Your reflexes are still slow.
Maybe for a Witcher.
Think drowners or striggers will go.